Last time, we started adding the pedestal for the second robot to the factory by adding a simple box geometry to the Zagro. We saw that the defaults for properties like color, location, and the dimensions were not okay for our purposes. So in this video, we'll be making changes to those properties and we'll turn the box into a proper pedestal. We'll first adjust the size and shape, then raise the pedestal so it rests on the floor, change the color, and finally we'll update its location. So let's get back to our editor and open the Zagro file. So first let's open the file. Now scroll down to where we last edited the pedestal link and the joint for robot 2. First we'll make the box a bit taller by updating the size property. As always, ROS follows the X, Y, and Z convention here, so the first entry is for the size of the box in the X dimension. The second is for the Y dimension. And finally, the last is for Z, or the height of the box. Let's make the box twice as tall as it is wide. Now we'll need to raise it slightly to get it out of the floor. The reason it is in the floor right now is that primitive shapes have their origin at the center of the shape in URDF. The origin of a box is halfway between its top and bottom faces, and in the default case, this origin is located at the origin of the link that is the parent, which in this case is the world link. As the world link is at floor level in the middle of the factory, so is our pedestal box, which is why it is stuck in the floor. To fix this, we'll need to provide a new origin. We shift the visual geometry up by half its own height by putting a 0.3 in the last position, or the element for the z-coordinate. With that fixed, we still have to give the pedestal the correct color and place it in the right location. Colors are added to geometry primitives by adding a material element, so let's add one now. The name attribute allows us to reuse this material for other objects in the URDF, but for now this is only applied to the pedestal. Finally, as we'll be using a solid color for the pedestal, we need to add a color element. These colors are defined as a mixture of red, green, and blue. The last number defines how saturated the color or how transparent the object is. For this pedestal, we'll reuse the blue color of the shelf stands. So let's set the values of the RGB entries. Our pedestal is completely opaque, so that's why I specify a value of 1 there. Let's see what our pedestal looks like now. I'll first save the Zagro file, then switch to the terminal, and then we have to relaunch the visualization launch file to start ARVIS. That looks much better, but it's still in the wrong location, so we cannot put the robot on it. Let's move it to the correct place in the factory. Just as a reminder, this is where we are expected to place the pedestal. The coordinates for this location are similar to those of the bin, so we can use those as a starting point. We're going to do this in exactly the same way as when we moved the bin in the previous unit, by adding an origin element and setting the XYZ coordinates to the correct values. We'll start by adding a basic origin element. As we are not going to rotate the pedestal, we'll only specify a value for the X, Y, and Z coordinates. The location we've chosen is at 7.8 meters in the negative X direction and 1.5 meters in the negative Y direction, relative to the center of the factory where the world frame is located. This places the pedestal right behind the pallet with the boxes on it and right next to the bin. Of course, the pedestal should still be on the floor, so I've kept the z-coordinate 0. Let's do a final check and inspect our result. Don't forget to save the file again, switch to the terminal, and then relaunch the visualization launch file. Now we have a pedestal. It's still a box, but it's in the right location, has a proper color, and it's no longer stuck halfway in the floor. We now have just about everything in the factory that we need. The Turtlebot can drive right next up to the pedestal, coming from robot 1, and deliver the part it's carrying to robot 2 to be placed in the bin. So wrapping up, we can mark the adding the pedestal task on our list as completed and start working on the next one, which will consist of adding a second robot to the factory. For that, we'll be able to reuse an existing model, and we'll mount that on the pedestal in the next video.